Hello everyone. Today I thought I'd take the opportunity to look at Darktable 3.2.1 and revisit the topic of how a new user might start off in Darktable using one of the three possibilities for how Darktable will treat your images on import. So we're going to look at the same image today and we're going to go through the options that Darktable provides for import. So the first thing I'm going to do is take this image out of my library so that I'm starting from scratch. So I'm going to go back to the light table and I'm going to select this image and remove it. Now I'm going to switch to my file system and I'm going to delete the XMP file for that. Now what I've done is I've made three copies of the same file here and we're going to go through Darktable's options. Okay, so the option that most new users are going to, I'll say expect, is they're going to expect Darktable to make the image look something like it did on the back of the camera using the embedded JPEG profiles. So the way Darktable accomplishes this is with the base curve module and auto sharpening. Now with the new version 3.2.1, these options are a little bit more obvious and easy to set up. So we're going to go into processing and this auto apply pixel workflow defaults. We're going to change this to display referred. This is going to be the default when you install Darktable. And we're going to auto apply camera base curve presets and we're going to auto apply sharpening. Now display referred tells us that we need to restart Darktable, so I'm going to go ahead and do that and I'll see you back here when that's done. Okay, Darktable has been restarted and now what I'm going to do is import the image that I call base. So we're going to pick that one and open it. Now we have an image that looks more or less like the JPEG did on the back of the camera, and if we look at the modules over here we see that sharpen and base curve have both been applied along with the standard modules that are applied in any case, and we see that our histogram falls mostly within gamut. And if I toggle the over under exposed, I have a specular highlight here that's overexposed and an area here that's overexposed in at least one channel. That's to be expected and I probably can't bring those back. If I look at the raw over under exposure, I actually don't have anything completely overexposed in RAW, so I could bring that down if I wanted to, but I don't really see the need for that. So this image for most people is probably going to be more or less done, but I would say that your average user starting out is going to want to make some adjustments to this, and most of which can be done with the basic adjustments module. So I'm going to go into basic adjustments module, and overall I think the exposure looks pretty good, but maybe I want to bring the brightness up, which won't increase my highlights, but it'll increase the brightness of the midtones. And then maybe I'm going to want to jack up my saturation and turn up the contrast until the image looks the way I want it to look. Your mileage may vary, of course. Everybody's going to do this to their own liking. And if I zoom in on this, I see that it looks pretty good, nice and sharp. There's a little bit of noise in this image, but not enough that I would be inclined to apply any noise reduction. We'll look at noise reduction on one of the other processing options instead of this one. This is the most basic, in my opinion, option that a new user will use in order to get a file that looks close to what he saw on the back of his camera. We talked about this before. Darktable doesn't know about your special camera Filmic settings and profiles and your Kodachrome setting and all those other things, your various Fuji Pro settings. It doesn't know about those and it's not going to be able to emulate them. It's going to apply a standard base curve, and if you want other base curves to be applied, the best way to handle that is with styles, which I'm not going to cover in this video. Alright, so the next option we want to look at is the newest option in Darktable, which is to auto-apply Filmic and what they call a pixel referred image workflow. So we go back to processing and we apply pixel workflow instead of display referred to scene referred, not pixel referred, I'm sorry. I'm going to turn off auto-apply camera base curve presets and I'm going to turn off sharpening. And again, I'm going to have to restart Darktable, so I'll see you back here after that's done. Okay, and we're back. So now I'm going to make sure that those settings were saved properly. So I'll go into processing, and I see it's at scene referred, which it tells me is going to apply the Filmic and exposure modules. So let's import the image that I've saved as Filmic. It's the same raw file, and we see here a different starting point than we saw with the base curve. So Filmic, let's take a look at what's happened here. When we look at the exposure module, we see that it's compensated for camera exposure, and some settings have been made here. A half a EV plus, which is basically to get middle gray to 18%. I could change that if I wanted to make the image brighter. So I can go ahead and roll that up to make the image brighter. And again, if I look at my overexposure indications, I'm not too worried about these specular highlights. I can probably go about a stop and a half to get the histogram more or less or in the center of the scale. Then let's look at what Filmic has done. So this is the new version of Filmic, and I'll confess to have not dove into this tremendously, but we see that it no longer asks us what percentage gray is being used. It assumes you're coming in with an 18% gray image, which you control through adjustments in the exposure module, as we just did. And then it sets white and black relative exposures to basically preserve the highlights and preserve the shadows and to extend the dynamic range. And then we have a lot of new options here in Filmic, but if we leave it alone out of the box and don't change anything, we get a pretty good looking exposure. And then we can come, if we want more contrast, we can add more contrast here and bring that up instead of going into the color balance module or into some other module. And then we can also improve the saturation of the midtones in this section if we want to. And we get an image that has a nice appeal, but certainly looks different than our other image. So this is the Filmic based image, and if I hit spacebar and we go to the base curve image, we can definitely see that there are some differences in how the blues are rendered. Let's take a look at these in the culling mode. So I'm going to go here. Well, even in the film strip view, we can see that the base curve image is a bit brighter. Now I did turn the brightness up on that, which I could do the same thing in the Filmic image. The Filmic has rendered the blues a little bit differently, and also I think the saturation in the bird is better in Filmic. Let's take a look at these two in culling. And we can see that I didn't apply sharpening with the Filmic module, so it definitely looks a little bit softer around the bird's eye. So I could go back and apply sharpening if I want to, or I can use the recommended method, which is the local contrast method. And I'll turn on local contrast. And again, I can apply that more to shadows and highlights, or however I want to control it. But if I look at that, we'll turn that off. Turn that back on, and we can see that is increased the sharpness. I could also use the contrast equalizer if I wanted to get the sharpness of the finest details to be a little bit punchier. There we go. Now I've also increased the sharpness of the grain, but it really brought out the detail around the eye, which is what I was looking for. So we'll go back to the light table and look in culling mode. The image on the left and the image on the right have pretty equivalent levels of sharpness. The image on the left has better colors, in my opinion, but the image on the right has a little less grain or a little less noise. All right, so that's the second method that we have. And the last method we have is to tell Darktable to do nothing when it brings the image in. So let's show how we do that. We come back here to processing, and we change this to none, and we leave off base curve, and we leave off auto apply sharpen, and once again we'll restart and then come right back in, and here we are. So we're going to import one more time, and I'm going to import the image that says none, and we can see right away that the image appears much darker than it did in any of the previous versions. And down here in the film strip, you can see how much darker it is than the process versions that we've done before. But you know, all is not lost. This is still this image can be brought back very easily using really only one or at the most two modules. So I'm going to look at, in this case, I'm going to look at basic adjustments. We're just going to come into basic adjustments. We're going to turn on our overexposure indicator, and we're going to bring up the exposure to the point where we start to see maybe some overexposure in the bird, and then we'll back off just a little bit so that I don't see any overexposure in the bird's beak, so maybe around 1 EV. Now if that's still not bright enough, I can use the brightness control, and I can bring up the middle grays without affecting the highlights. And let's stay there. Let's turn up the saturation and the vibrance. And let's increase contrast. Okay, now we're starting to get an image that looks pretty good without a whole lot of effort. We can probably bring down our highlights a little bit with highlight compression. All in one module here, just adjusting a couple of sliders. And okay, now we're going to need to do a little sharpening on this, because if we zoom in on it, it's probably going to be a little bit soft around the eye, just like it was before. In this case, I'm just going to use the sharpen module, but I'll show you the results. We'll use sharpen. That's default. We get a pretty nice change. This is off and this is on. Using local contrast, we can turn it on and we get that result off. So it's basically up to you which method you prefer. As I have said before, I often use the contrast equalizer, and I'm going to turn the contrast equalizer on, and I'm going to focus on the fine details because I want feather detail in the bird there. Very nice. Now maybe I've brought in a little bit of grain through the noise, so here's where I'm just going to show you how to use the denoise. In case you have this is not a noisy image, but you might have a noisier image than this. Click denoise profile, don't change anything. The noise in the background is gone, and the bird's feathers are still nice and sharp. And if I turn denoise off, and we look at the bird's feathers, we really don't see any change between denoise off and denoise on, but we see a much smoother background. And we can jump out to light table, and we now have three images from three different starting points using three different processes, and they're not perfectly consistent, but all three have a nice look and all three are good representations of the final image. And of course, all three could be processed further. So really, there's no right or wrong way. There's the preferred workflow in Darktable today, which is the Filmic workflow, which is this one here. And what we can see Filmic has done is it's really preserved the highlight very nicely in this overexposed orange thing, whatever this is, hanging on the fence. And the darks look a little bit better. To me, the Filmic is the best option. But it does take a little bit more understanding of the inner workings to process the image afterwards. If you want to go with the base curve module, you can get a very nice result. And of course, if you don't want Darktable to apply anything and you want to start with a pure RAW file, you can also get a good result. So I hope that was useful. I think I'm going to stop talking about this subject. It's sort of been beat to death. Hopefully it's clear to you now where you go to turn those options on and off and how they affect how the file comes into Darktable. If you have any questions, please leave comments on my YouTube video, and I'll be happy to try to answer them in a future video. Thank you very much.